just like Jeremiah. He said to her, listen, go ye out to the nation. And you are ordained as a prophet. And today we are here and honored by God. I'd like to introduce my very beautiful sister, Innocent Sadiki, a prophet, a woman of God, and a voice of this nation. Innocent Sadiki, may God speak through you. May God sing through you. And God never ever releases a word that comes back void. I know whatever is going to be released in this altar is going to come into life. Amen. Amen. Come on, somebody give Jesus praise.
Amen. is innocent Sadiki. By the grace of God, I am honored and humbled to be able to stand upon an altar of this magnitude,
set
atmosphere. There's none like being in the presence of the prophetic. Because that's where things are activated in the spirit.
Amen.
The prophetic is a powerful office. Very powerful office. Because it brings life even to words. You speak things and they become, because you are in the prophet. You speak with authority because you've been given power and authority to speak things and they become. So a prophetic atmosphere, it needs maturity. Because you don't speak recklessly. You don't speak recklessly. You are aware of the things that you speak.
Would you want to bless your
country?
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 change in your life.
Come on.
Gifts.
Oh, so you do it.
You got.
Tell you what we're creating.
your gift. Watch it. Protect it. Be jealous of your gift. Okay. We are all born with a gift. I don't care who you are. You are born with a gift. Now in the name of Jesus, your gift had to be unleashed in this season. Because it is not unleashed in this season. Why should Isha? In the name of Jesus, your gift must be unlocked in this season. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, your gift must be operational in this season. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Your gift must be made manifest.
Even though my mother didn't even know me,
but you watch me.
Yeah.
Show you, like, who are you? When did you come from? How come you didn't meet? meet you. 5 years ago. Where have you been? All this time. Because your steps are ordered by God. By the time you walk in the room, they are mesmerized.
Generational curses
in the name of Jesus.
school.
Oh yes.
your gift. That's number one. Number two, your gift will make room for you. That's your gift. It will make room for you. You, when you don't have to open or make room for yourself,
or
your gift. That's number two. Number three, your gift will qualify you.
It will qualify.
Yeah. It will qualify.
It will qualify.
God bless you. Number four, your gifts are given to you for free.
If you love my heart.
Are you writing, Bazaran?
Number five,
your gift can change your life. And gifts are not about how old you are. Never. Whether you are 10
or
you are
80,
your gift can change your life. Jesus. Last one, number six. For every gift, there's a birthing time. For every gift, there's a birthing time. Encounter. That means your gift. You go through seasons in your life. Like a person who carries something. Like a pregnant person.
Yeah,
according to the same spirit, to another faith.
tolo.
To another, the gift of prophecy. To another, the ability to distinguish between spirits. These are all gifts. And to another, kind of tongue. And to another, the interpretation of tongues. These are gifts. Listen. God, I will preach the gospel. And I will do it very well. God, you're going to bless me. God, is faithful.
And I want to
when you want, when you want. China. Otherwise, Genesis 29:32. Yeah. Praise God. Do you want to read for me, my friend?
Leah became pregnant and gave birth to a son. She said, "The Lord has seen my trouble."
Listen to this.
Tell it to me.
So, Leah.
Leah.
There was no children.
Who was in the man?
There were trouble.
Baba got 20.
A lot of trouble.
And what did the 20
do? In fact,
how
his husband was not happy.
But now how was
that? Because the husband wanted sons.
Now when the man in the man was
married, he moved. I did not call. But I want you to listen to the scripture.
Man, we never let tell it in this.
And the secret of blessing.
She said, "The Lord has seen my trouble.
The Lord has seen my trouble.
And now my husband will love me."
Yes.
So she named him Reuben.
Yes.
She became pregnant again.
This is the first blessing. Okay? So the first son was Reuben.
What
was
the woman in Reuben?
This is the part where she was supposed to celebrate.
What
was
that time?
And thought that God
and even
was done with her.
Who said it again?
Simeon, number two, read my friend.
Once again,
once again.